Welcome guys. I haven't uploaded in a while these Act 7.2 paths because I was pretty busy and occupied, but now it's time to finish the Act 7.2 exploration playlist by uploading the last few remaining paths as well. So, in this video I will be taking the Mercy path in the fourth quest of Act 7.2. The main node on this path is Mercy, which basically hampers all of our damage output on base hits. The only way to deal normal damage is by building the Mercy charges. Every time we trigger Dexterity, a Mercy charge is built and they stack as well. To put them to use, simply parry and they will be activated and we will start doing normal damage. Each Mercy charge only lasts for 1.5 seconds, so in order to get some damage going, it's advisable to build a lot of Mercy charges before you activate them with a parry. Once they are activated, try to be as aggressive as possible. Additionally, there is a node called Mutagenic Acceleration which helps our cause as it increases the power rate of mutants and special damage of tech champions respectively. So, using mutant and tech champions is quite helpful. The fights are going to be longer than usual because of the damage reduction we get, so we need to be patient and take the fights slow. Some people have also been trying to turn off Mercy node with the likes of Quake and Archangel, but in my opinion the time and effort to clear these fights while trying to turn off the Mercy node is greater than simply playing around the Mercy node mechanic. So, it's not even worth bothering to turn off Mercy node. The best champ I found for this path is Stark Enhanced Spider-Man, because while building the Mercy charges with Dexterity you are also building up Poise charges and greatly increasing critical rate and damage, and with increased damage on specials for tech champions, his SP2 can be quite devastating to the opponents. I brought Warlock, Apocalypse, Warlock as well, since they are pretty strong, sustainable and can benefit from Mutagenic Acceleration. Nick Fury was brought to handle Invisible Woman on the path. The defenders on the path are not that hard. There is another node called Bubble Shield which reduces block proficiency, and a 10 hit into the block is unblockable as well. It will keep catching me off guard and messing me up from time to time. So, keep an eye on that node as well. That's it for the path. For the final boss, I will just crush Man-Thing with Immortal Abomination. It's a very easy final boss. That's it for this video, good luck and I will catch you in the next video.
Thank you.